Bethlehem.
Yeah.
When did you write that one?
I wrote that in February or March in New York with Mark Ronson. And we were just walking down the street and I sang the hook. And he burst out laughing. He said, "Who's that?" I said, "Well, I just made it up." And he was like, that would be really cool. And I said, "Dad, listen, let's go to the studio now. I can knock it out now."
You went straight there and did it just like that?
Yeah, literally.
It's like your voice has become more powerful. Your songwriting's become stronger. Do you feel all those things are happening?
I'm very proud of this record. And I feel that, you know, unless I could have bettered myself, then with the last album, you know, I might as well give up.
Mm. And it's a great sort of different vibration. It's got a sort of a Motown groove, isn't it?
Yes.
What's the first music that you listened to, though?
A lot of jazz, really. A lot of Sarah Vaughan. There's loads of Sarah Vaughan songs. April in Paris. But I think one of my earliest memories is listening to my granddad play Tenderly, my pop Larry, God rest his soul, Tenderly.
And what, did your granddad play an instrument or he'd play it on a record?
No, he'd play it. He'd play it on, you know, off a record, well, yeah.
Tenderly. Do you know how to sing that?
Yes.
Would you give that a go?
Yeah.
Should we give Tenderly a go? Well, I think we should, let's get a tempo, hang on. Could you give us a bit of this?
The evening breeze caressed the trees, tenderly. The evening breeze caressed the trees, tenderly. I can't forget how two hearts met breathlessly. Your arms over mine and took me inside. You took my love, you took my heart so breathless, tenderly.
Oh, your granddad would love that. We love it too. Amy Winehouse.
Thanks for having me.